Sure, Anjana, what I'll do is I'll take a step back to say that there are two types of marketing programs we do. We're actually a B2B2C company. So we do B2C, which is to the consumer, as well as B2B, which is our partners, like you said, with ICICI and SBI Cards. So I'll talk about the consumer one is what we do, on mass media to speak to all our consumers. But as you would know, you have a card, I'm sure. And when someone asks you, what card do you have? You would always say, I have a Standard Chartered Bank card or an ICICI card. You would very rarely say, I have a Visa card or,
Right.
or so that is why, in India, it's actually a very different situation. We don't have consumers of our own. Our consumers are always through the issuing partners that we have in our banks. So it's very important that in marketing, we communicate through our issuers as well, our partners, as well as direct to consumers. So that's why we just wanted to specify, that's why we actually call ourselves a B2B2C, which is consumer. So on this particular one that you're talking about, we've actually run three big client marketing campaigns in the recent past, ICICI, SBI Cards, and actually HDFC. I'll talk about the first two. So as you may know, today almost all cards, new cards that are issued in the market are contactless. And when I say contactless, if you look at your card, you'll have a sort of a reverse Wi-Fi sign on it. And if that is there, it means actually for purchases up to now 5,000, it was 2,000 till January 1st, you don't even have to hand over your card to the merchant. You just tap it on the POS machine, the point of sale machine, and the amount gets credited to the merchant. And that is a big thing because especially in the last year during the pandemic, as you know, we've tried to move away from touching cash. We've tried to move away from giving our cards to people, and we just want to hold it ourselves. So that's been a big campaign. So what we did with both SBI and ICICI was on contactless cards. And as I mentioned, prior to Jan 1st, the limit that you could use your contactless cards was up to 2,000 rupees. The Reserve Bank of India, as of January 1st of this year, increased the limits from 2,000 to 5,000, which is a big thing because that covers, almost more than 90% of transactions that consumers do. So the fact that you can now use your card, tap it, not let it leave your hand during this phase was a big, big point to communicate. So we did that in our consumer media, but then we also tied up. So actually, SBI Cards has tied up with us three times already in the past 2 years, to do co-marketing campaigns. And this was the third focused on the contactless limit increase to say that you could increase now up to 5,000, where we used one of our creatives. And what we do is we develop advertisements, Anjana, and each one, we only give one particular creative to one partner. So one was given to SBI Cards, which was around when you go to eat in a QSR, and it shows a mother actually just tapping the kiosk and buying her children's purchases for food. So we tied up with SBI Cards and, for that film. And similar, we had another one which was in the supermarket scenario, a mother and a small baby, and we used that with ICICI Bank. So both campaigns were to communicate the new limit increase in partnership with our issuing partners. Both had very, very strong results. In fact, I can separately, just, share with you, we have all the metrics of, the campaigns we've done, how they've reached. And we've advertised them on across social and digital media for client marketing campaigns, and then traditional offline media for consumer. Both have seen very, very strong results. The client partners have been very, very happy with them as well, and that's why I said, like with SBI Cards, it's our third co-marketing campaign that we've done, and they've done this exclusively with Visa each time. And the one with ICICI Bank was also exclusive with Visa. Yeah, so that's a great point you've touched on. So the purpose, that we want to do is to help consumers go from cash to cashless. And that's, the, you know, so therefore, that's the term that we've used for our marketing initiatives. We classify them as cashless. And there are two different, you know, ways we look at cashless. One is through e-commerce and online payments, and one is through face-to-face with contactless. Both are very important. Talking about the point you've touched on, this limit increase is very, very important, Anjana, because like I said, in the last pandemic, what we've seen is people are, one, very, very hesitant to go out. When they go out, you know, we want to minimize contact as much as possible with anyone. And so this limit increase to 5,000, like I said, covers most transactions that, you know, Indians do on a daily basis. So the fact that they're able to just tap their card, never let it leave their hand, and, you know, just go, literally, we call it tap and go. You don't have to wait to collect change. You don't have to put in an OTP pin, nothing. You just tap it and go. So it's been very good for two reasons. One, it's helped people, you know, have the safety that they want in terms of no touching, of, you know, handing over their cards to merchant, as well as security that their card never leaves their hand. So it's completely secure, the transaction. They don't have to worry about that. And overall, it also saves a lot of time because, you know, what we've seen is when people go to shops, if they give cash, you have to wait to get cash back. It actually, that makes it a longer transaction. So this makes it a faster, safer, and much more secure transaction. So it's been a big step for us. We're very happy that the limit was increased from 2,000 to 5,000. And we think that this will be the way going forward. We're very, very happy to have PV Sindhu as part of our family. So you would may be aware that globally, Visa has been sponsoring the Olympics for many, many years now, and we've still signed on to sponsor it in more years. So it's something globally very big. For example, in the venues, Visa is the only payment form factor that's allowed. And basically, we, you know, when we signed it on, it's not just a brand building exercise, but it's actually to help promote the athletes as well, which is why we never call them brand ambassadors, but we call them Team Visa athletes. And they're actually, so Sindhu is the first athlete we signed on from India as a Team Visa athlete, and she becomes part of more than 50 Team Visa athletes that we have globally. So, you know, she also becomes part of a larger family, and, you know, we look at ways to partner them in different ways. For us, Sindhu was the, you know, really the automatic choice. She stands for so much that our brand stands for. You've seen her playing, you know, the passion that she puts into each one of her shots, and the, you know, the way she just is such a fighter is something that we really sort of identify with. She was a silver medalist in the last Olympics, and she is probably the largest gold medalist hope for the upcoming Olympics. So she was really the natural choice. She's been wonderful to work with. I've interacted her with a lot over the past 2 years. Unfortunately, due to COVID, the Olympics weren't able to happen last year. Fingers crossed that it happens in July this year. You would have seen news. They're still up back and forth on whether it's going to finally happen. As of now, the IOC says it's definitely going to happen. We know we've engaged with her in many ways. We've, you know, brought her into our core messaging of tap to pay. So where we had a communication where, you know, we had many people who met Sindhu tapping to pay for her, and they basically said, you tap for India, we'll tap for you. You know, acknowledging the role that she plays into sport in India. Apart from that, we also had her communicate a lot of, you know, relevant messaging. So last year, when hand washing was a very big thing for COVID, we had her actually, you know, on social media talking about wash hands like an Olympian. And, you know, where she showed herself playing badminton and saying, this is tough. And then she showed herself washing hands. So saying, you know, this is easy. So please everyone do it. So she's a wonderful brand ambassador. We're very happy to have her as a Team Visa athlete. We're trying to support her in any way possible from the whole Team Visa family globally in having her as a part of that family. We're engaging with her through, you know, clients as well as, you know, through the consumers who get to see a lot of the interactions that she does. And, you know, we have signed her on for 2 years. She's still, you know, we will have her on for one more year and hope, you know, we may look at relooking at that, taking that further. but very, very happy to have her, and we wish her all the best for the upcoming Olympics.